As you know, I've been working on a new trading plan, and listen closely because the difference between my current trading plan and this new one is that I've been forward testing my new trading plan to add to my journal, and I want to show you another example of it today. And I'll of course show you all the necessary proof here. So on the 15 minute, something interesting here is this gap, because this is a Monday on Halloween. So we came back from the weekend and we left this gap. And also this fair value gap around the 50% fib of Friday. So let's now go on the 5 minutes, 3 minutes and 2 minutes. Some nice fair value gaps here, even before 9:30. Actually multiple ones, run right there, one right there, another one just like right there with an execution here. So if some people would like to trade before 9:30, you can see here the potential of always. Let's now wait for the 9:30 open. So at 9:30, we had a big push to take out all the people who would maybe sold here around 9, put their stop losses here, and then we would see this big push right there, taking today's low. From this point here, we have this huge fair value gap, a displacement of 600 breaking this low right there. However, I will not take this one because of the execution time. I need the execution time to be around 9:55 and after. Because around those times, there is still a lot of volatility, and that's the reason why I'm not trading around 9:30. You see, if you really wanted to take this trade, you would need to put your order here to take the entry of the fair value gap. Or maybe here if you want to use a breaker, I think this is a breaker. You can check ICT's YouTube channel about that. But still, you would need quite a big stop loss. You would need at least to cover the high here, because you never know what could happen. So this is another reason why I'm not trading around 9:30. Then we had another push, leaving a fair value gap here, but the displacement is not enough. After going back down, we saw another small fair value gap right there. I'm going to show it right there that we filled, and then we look like we're going back down. All right, so it's getting messy from this point, so I don't like those type of trades, but you can see here this kind of second leg, very messy, with kind of a fair value gap from this point to this point. Let me clean everything else. So if you wanted to take this one, you would need to put your order right there with a stop loss of at least 250, just like that. But I would consider this trade not following my initial trading plan. It would be more a trade that would fit my second trading plan with the continuation, because this is not as clean as I would like it to be for my first trading plan. You can see a quite messy leg right there. So I would not like those type of trades, especially since we already took out the liquidity right there at today's low. However, if we go back to the 5 minutes, remember the fair value gap that I showed here, which is around the 50% fib of Friday's price action. This is usually a great place to take out a lot of liquidity. I think because also if you look at on the 15 minutes, if I'm not wrong, again, I'm not too good with order blocks. I think this is an order block, or maybe this here. I'm not too sure, you can tell me in the comments, but I feel like it could be a great place to take out some liquidity. And this is the trade that I took. So I felt like this move right there was quite a clean one. You can see here those two consecutive candles. Here the displacement is 500. But like I explained, I don't know if I will still be using the 600 displacement for the continuation model, as many times continuation legs are not as aggressive as the initial leg we see at the beginning of the move. I went with this one. I wanted to cover at least those high right there, so I've put my order right there. And I went for at least 2.5, which matched the fair value gap that we talked about before, just like that. And I'm going to show you the proof at the end. So we had the order filled right there. And for the people wondering, let's measure this leg. Only 300, leaving this fair value gap. So I would not take this one as a buy. I didn't talk about this fair value gap, I just saw it. But it would have been a nice other entry right there with this candle, just like that, covering the top. And then going for the same target. However, as I said, the only trade that I took for testing is this one. And there you go. For a nice 2.5 here, 1.2 here, and a 3.9 here. And it was actually the low of the day. To be honest, it was kind of a coincidence. I didn't plan on taking the low of the day, but let me show you now the executions. So I sold around here, 51 contracts, and then bought here, 51 contracts for testing, of course, on demo, to have enough data to make sure I have some good rules to be able to use it in real markets. And if you want to know about the pyramid risk management I'm using for this model, watch this episode where I show a $4,000 trade.